FileMaker with HubSpot. The first thing we're going to want to do right here is go into the HubSpot developer account, create one. I've already got one, so I'll just go forward with that. But once you get into here, you'll have to create an application if you don't have one already. So I'm just going to create this public one, create it as FileMaker. You can name this whatever you want, but I'll just create this one right here. And then go into the settings of the application. So right now we've gotten these two steps taken care of. Next, the only thing that you guys really need to do, at least to get this example file to work, is check the OAuth. This just basically allows you to connect to HubSpot using FileMaker and the OAuth security authentication. And then the example file is strictly just working with contacts right now, so you want to allow that. If you're going to be in your live system, if you're going to be working with anything else, you'll have to make sure that whatever you're working with, the checkboxes you have in here correspond with that. So we'll go ahead and save this. These other fields you certainly can enter in. It gives more information for the user who's connecting their app with their HubSpot account, but it's not mandatory, especially if it's just an internal system for yourself. But we will need, if we move on forward, we will need the client ID and the client secret. So we'll go ahead and copy these, paste them in. And so that gives us this last. We just need to enter in a redirect URL or URI. It doesn't matter what you enter in, really. For this, it has to be a HTTPS website. So for us, we're going to use the DB Services account, her website. But, it could be your own website. The purpose of this is if you had, like, a web application or something, and after they log in, you wanted it to take them to a certain page, that's it would do. But for our purposes, it doesn't really matter what you put in. You can put in any kind of HTTPS website that doesn't give you an error. It would have to be a valid certificate website. So, again, DB Services website will work, so we'll go forward with that. So now that we got all these entered in, we're going to go on and request the access. So what this is going to do, this is going to, behind the scenes, is going to do some scripting here that's going to open up or go to a web page and set some variables in the URL parameters, and then it's going to have us sign in here with account that I have. So with the developer account, you get this sandbox account that you can use as well. So I believe that's this one. Okay. So then it's basically saying that they're wanting to access contacts and that sort of thing. So depending on what you check, this might say different things. But we'll go ahead, move forward. So took us to the DB Services page. We have scripting that pulls a code parameter out of the address, so when it redirected to dbservices.com, in the URL itself, it put a code equals parameter, and we grab that code, and that lets us go on forward to the authentication of getting an access token, a refresh token. If you looked in the scripting, you'll be able to see what's going on there. So here we have this create company option, and basically we go ahead and click this button. It's going to create the company inside of our HubSpot account. So let's see if I can get into there. I just have to find which one I did. I think it would be this one. Contacts, that's what it would be. Or companies, I think I created a company. So today, just created this DB Services company. With this information inside of here. And when I create it, you can see the results back that we get. That all comes inside of here. And if we wanted to update it, so let's do DB Services example. Let's go ahead and update this company. If we refresh our page in here, we're going to see now it's DB Services example. And essentially what we're doing in here, we're using FileMaker 16's JSON capabilities that it has now. And if we just take a look at one of these scripts, either the create, update, either one, we're using the JSON in here to build up the the request data, and then we're putting that inside of, again, FileMaker 16's curl options. I'm building the curl inside of here with using OAuth 2.0. We have to use bearer as an option, and then this access token that we got in the beginning, and then we're passing it as data. This little at sign is something that really FileMaker only does with curl options, but basically what's happening here is we're setting this as a data flag, and then anything after this at, it's basically telling FileMaker that this isn't text string that we're passing. We're giving it, you know, look at the actual variable itself, not just, you know, this word dollar sign data. So it's actually passing what's in the variable itself. And so that gets passed in the request, and then it gives us a response back. Whether it's successful or not, we find out, but we're setting this field right here with the response back. Hopefully this is helpful for you, and if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Thanks.